Good morning. We're going to take a few minutes. We're actually given an award this morning that represents an alum of Aquinas. And most of you pass this picture, or this portrait, every day in the hallway after you come in the back door. Don Holleder was class of 1952. And some of you probably don't know who that is in terms of some of the things that he did here at Aquinas and afterwards. So we're going to show a short video with clips from a documentary that was made this year for his 60th reunion from West Point. So go ahead and play the video.
He was most fortunate to spend his high school years at Aquinas Institute, Rochester's renowned Catholic high school. The school had a reputation for high scholastic standards and outstanding sports teams. Don loved challenges, making the varsity Aquinas teams in football, basketball, and baseball gave him the chance to learn teamwork, sportsmanship, and leadership. The Aquinas coaches were all outstanding. They saw in Holly a talented athlete, but even more, a young man with natural leadership skills and the grit and determination of a winner. By his junior year, college football scouts were encouraging him to commit to their schools. The limited substitution rule in college football in the 1950s meant that players had to play both offense and defense. This made Holleder, with his speed, toughness, and stamina, an ideal recruit. Being a Catholic school with a great football program, Notre Dame was a natural fit for Don and the other outstanding football players at Aquinas High School. And by the early 1950s, Coach Frank Leahy had taken Notre Dame to the pinnacle of success, and Leahy fully expected Don to come to his school. Tragedy struck the Holleder home in June of 1950. Don's father, Wally, had suffered with blood pressure problems for years, and on the night of June 28th, he died at the young age of 41. Wally died in the arms of his 15-year-old son. The sudden and tragic death left an indelible mark on Don's future. A future that would no longer be with Notre Dame, but with West Point, his father's wish. As spring practice began in 1955, Coach Blake had a tough decision to make. Who would he pick for Army's quarterback to replace Peter Vann for the coming season? Blake's very controversial decision gained two nicknames, The Great Experiment and Blake's Folly. In his autobiography, You Have to Pay the Price, Coach Blake devotes a full chapter to Holleder. The chapter was entitled, You Are My Quarterback. To quote Blake, the saga of Holleder stands unique in Army and perhaps all of college gridiron lore. A quick, competitive 6'2", 187 pounds, he was also above average defensively and selected for most of the All-America teams. Yet, it is not as a great end that we remember Holleder, so much as a boy who gladly gave up personal glory for the good of the team.
Grenades were coming in on us, and Chinese Claymore mines were being popped. Most people there were wounded. There were very few that weren't wounded. So we were pulling back, supporting these wounded, fighting our way out. When we came out of the jungle into the open ground, there were some troops that come out from the night defensive position and we could turn these wounded over to them. And just about that time, a major came running up with two or three men with him. Never saw him before. And he said, "Come on, Doc, there's wounded in there. Let's go get them." And he went running ahead of us. We warned him that there was still firing coming in, snipers. And an AK-47 opened up out of the tree line and cut the major down. I closed my eyes and I can see a brave sergeant standing up and providing cover fire for me. And I'll never, you know, I don't know if he killed the enemy, but he quieted them down. And I got to the major and just started to put the first bandage on him, and he died. I found out later that that was Major Don Holleder.
So this award, this is called the Lifeline Award, which is the name of Don's infantry when he was in Vietnam. And it goes to a football player, as he was at West Point and Aquinas here, but it's a leadership award. So at this time, I'd like to call another Aquinas alum, class of 1948, Major General Rappel, to the stage.
Throughout the year while carrying the team on his shoulders. His belief that the team came before his personal success was an example not only to our team, coaches, and players' parents, but to the whole Aquinas community. Congratulations, Jamir.